You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host, Skyrim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. Let's begin the show with Jammu and Kashmir, which is one of the most magnificent tourist destinations in India. Home to lush green valleys, snow-clad mountains, and a colorful, vibrant culture, the Union Territory still has a number of beautiful destinations that are yet to be discovered. Today, we will take you to one such destination named Dudh Pathri, where recently the Dudh Pathri Festival was organized. If there is paradise on earth, it is here, it is here. These words by the Mughal Emperor Jahangir vividly illustrating the beauty of the territory of Jammu and Kashmir. The land of snow-clad, lush green valleys and abundant flora and fauna still has a number of tourism marvels that are yet to be explored. One such place is Dudh Pathri, a magnificent hill station in Budgam district, which is covered with meadows of pine, fir and deodar. To unravel its beauty and promote it as a tourism hotspot, the village recently played host to a three-day festival. Organized by the Indian Army, the festival also tried to showcase the rich art and culture of the Union Territory.
ये जो प्रोग्राम्स हैं वो हम एक पूरे सिविल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन की तहत के अंदर करते हैं ताकि जिस तरह उनकी जो एक काबिलियत है उनकी जो एक पहुंच है हम उसको एक थोड़ा सा सप्लीमेंट कर सकें वरना आप देख ही रहे हैं कि आज की तारीख में पूरा जो टूरिज्म की तरफ एक माहौल है एक बहुत ही अच्छा माहौल है रिकॉर्ड किस्म के टूरिस्ट आ रहे हैं बाहर के तो टूरिस्ट हैं ही हैं बट लोकल टूरिस्ट बहुत सारे आ रहे हैं
The festival saw a number of dance and music performances that filled the atmosphere with vivid colors of joy and exuberance. Be it the high-spirit Punjabi dance, Bhangra, or the slow and simple Kashmiri dance, Rauf, every performance had the spectators on the edge of their seats. Locals say that more such festivals should be in Dudh Pathri so that it can give boost to both tourism as well as employment.
ये जो आज फेस्टिवल है इससे क्या होता है कि जो हमारा टूरिज्म यहाँ पे था मान लो कि जो दूध पथरी है इसको इधर इसको हाई लेवल पे लाने के लिए ये फेस्टिवल हो रहा है और ऐसे फेस्टिवल जो जो हमारे टूरिस्ट स्पॉट है ऐसे फेस्टिवल होने चाहिए क्योंकि हमारे जो यहाँ पे लोग रहते हैं उनको कम अज़ कम रोज़गार मिले और वो भी अच्छी तरह से अपनी ज़िंदगी बसर करें
Martial arts presentation was an interesting performance at the event that kept the audience hooked. The energetic youngsters demonstrated a number of martial arts stunts and tricks that the audience even captured in their phones. Horse race was yet another jaw-dropping performance that saw a number of participants racing against each other to reach the final point. Once all the events were over, winners were awarded with prizes by the Lieutenant General D.P. Pandey. Some supporters' items were also distributed among the differently abled people who expressed their gratitude for giving them preference at the event.
आज का ये जो प्रोग्राम था ये बहुत ही अच्छा प्रोग्राम था अगर आप देखें इसमें समाज का जो है हर एक फर्द हर एक बशर जो था वो शामिल था जैसे फिजिकली चैलेंज्ड कैटेगरी देखें आप तो हर जगह पे उन्हें पीछे रखा जाता है बट इट्स अ वेरी फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम पहला प्रोग्राम है जहां पर फिजिकली चैलेंज्ड लोगों को आप देखेंगे यहाँ अभी सबसे आगे थे इसके बाद जो है ओल्ड एज पीपल यंग चिल्ड्रंस सब लोग जो है इसमें इन्वॉल्व हुए तो ये प्रोग्राम जो है एक पॉजिटिव एटमोसफियर क्रिएट करेगा अमंग द सोसाइटी
With such events organized on regular basis at various off-peak destinations, will not just lead to inclusion in the itinerary of tourists, but also bring a revolution in the tourism industry of Jammu and Kashmir. It is a harmonious coexistence between citizens of different castes and communities in India that has left the entire world awestruck. A similar example is that of Aligarh City's statue making and polishing industry, which puts forward a picture of unified India. Take a look.
The Indian society stands as an undefeatable exemplar of the model of a multicultural harmonious society. This religious and peaceful existence could very well be seen at every nook and corner of the country. Aligarh's statue making and polishing industry has not only been making major contributions to the country's economy, but has also been putting forward a picture of the religious coexistence in the city.
की मूर्तियां बनती हैं सभी प्रकार की, जैसे गणेश, लक्ष्मी, दुर्गा, नंदी वगैरह, हनुमान वगैरह, ये सारे प्रकार की पीतल की मूर्तियां बनती हैं मेरे यहाँ। और मेरे यहाँ सभी वर्कर हैं, हिंदू और मुस्लिम दोनों मिलजुल कर काम करते हैं मेरे यहाँ। माहौल तो बहुत अच्छा है, ये भोपाल में माने नहीं रखता है कौन हिंदू है कौन मुस्लिम है।
Aligarh statue making industry is famous for making and polishing brass statues of Hindu gods and goddesses, especially on festivals like Durga Puja and Diwali. However, during the COVID-19 pandemic, the industry remained stagnant because of getting less business due to nationwide lockdown. Now, with the country returning back to normal, the industry has started regaining business. The industry employs both Hindus and Muslims who work tirelessly without any discrimination to polish these beautiful brass statues as well as a colorful picture of unified India.
सब तरह की जी सर, अब तो नवरात्रे आ रहे हैं, नवरात्रों के टाइम पे है दुर्गा मंदिर है, फिर दीपावली आ रही है हमारी, दीपावली के टाइम पे गणेश लक्ष्मी की मूर्ति बनेगी। और हमारे कारखाने में सभी भाई काम करते हैं, मुस्लिम भाई भी हैं, बहुत काम करते हैं, अच्छा काम करते हैं, हमारे यहाँ पे सब प्यार से रहते हैं। हमारे मालिक हैं राधे भाई साहब, दिनेश भाई साहब, जो हमारा बहुत ख्याल रखते हैं, बहुत अच्छे से काम कराते हैं।
It is due to examples like these that India stands united and unbreakable even in the most difficult times.
And now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A vintage vehicle lover organized an exhibition in India's western Pune city to create awareness on the maintenance of vintage beauties. Vinit Kenjale, who owns over 550 varieties of two-wheelers, organized the exhibition along with other vintage lovers, where vehicles ranging from 100-year-old cars, cars and bikes used in Second World War were on display.
अभी हमारे पास जो एक कार आई है आज, वो करीब करीब 100 साल हो गए हैं उसको। एक सेकंड वर्ल्ड वॉर में यूज़ की हुई एक वो भी कार आई है, कुछ बाइक्स है सेकंड वर्ल्ड वॉर में यूज़ किए हुए, ऐसे सब है, कुछ क्लासिक है, कुछ विंटेज है, और कुछ अभी 15 साल कंप्लीट किए हुए ऐसे भी कुछ है, कुछ 20-30 साल पुराने सब स्कूटर, और ये सब चलते हुए हैं।
The two-day exhibition was aimed at educating people about the government's scrap policy that says old vehicles need to clear a test for re-registration and vehicles older than 15 years should be scrapped. Young exiled Tibetan Buddhist monks from different countries are getting Buddhist teachings in India's northern Shimla city to carry their lineage and school forward. To carry forward the teaching of Buddhism, young lamas are getting education to become masters in Buddhist practices after a degree course of 9 years at the Dorje Drak Monastery of the Yangma School of Tibetan Buddhism.
आज 21st century में हम लोग क्या बोला दुनिया सब बदल जाते ना, इसलिए हमारा हम लोग बुद्धिज्म का मॉन्क लोग भी इस सेंचुरी का साथ जाना चाहिए ना, इसलिए हमारा ये लोग कंप्यूटर है, अभी का टेक्नोलॉजी ऑनलाइन थ्रू से इंग्लिश सीखना कर ले सीखने ये लोग सब बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है.
The students were seen chanting Buddhist verses and memorizing scriptures. They are also learning science, mathematics, computer science and English to gain an overall knowledge of the contemporary world. Dolje Drag Monastery is the main school of Yingmai School of Tibetan Buddhism. The Yingmai School is one of the important sects out of the four main schools including Sakya, Kagyu and Gelug of Tibetan Buddhism.
It's been said that if there is anything that violence can do, peace could do better. Mahatma Gandhi throughout his life propagated the message of peace and non-violence, which is still remembered by not just Indians but citizens all around the world. Recently, on the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti, a peace rally was carried out by citizens of different religious communities to showcase the bond of brotherhood between them and pay homage to the great leader. Gandhian principles of peace and harmony have not only acted as a guidance force for Indian citizens, but for people all over the world. Every year, these teachings are recalled and celebrated on the 2nd of October, on his birth anniversary. This year, in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, a peace rally was carried out by people of all communities, showcasing the bond of brotherhood between them and remembering the great freedom fighter.
ये पहली बार आज हम मना रहे हैं और झांकी यहां से जैसे आप देख रहे हो हमारे पीछे महात्मा गांधी जी का एक महान पुरुष था और उसका क्या मैसेज था कि पीस कोई वायलेंस नहीं अगर कोई गाल पर थप्पड़ मारता है तो उसको दूसरी गाल पेश करना है ये इस महापुरुष की एक गाथा कहानी थी.
Carried out in the famous Lal Chowk area of Jammu and Kashmir's summer capital, the rally aimed at propagating Bapu's messages of non-violence and peace. People of all caste and communities took part in the rally. Participants were seen holding a big banner which read Kashmir celebrates Gandhi Jayanti, March for Peace and Prosperity in Kashmir.
Ye peace hum Lal Chowk ke इसलिए लाना चाहते हैं ताकि यहाँ पर भी अवेयर हो जाए कि देखो जी महात्मा गांधी क्या चाहते थे. पीस चाहते थे, कोई बंदूक नहीं चाहते थे, कोई पत्थर नहीं चाहते थे, ये सार्वभौमिक शांति चाहते थे.
इंडिया ऑब्जर्व्स अक्टूबर 2nd नॉट ओनली एज गांधी जयंती, गांधी बर्थ एनिवर्सरी, बट ऑल्सो एज इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ नॉन वायलेंस, द आइडियल दैट गांधी फॉट फॉर थ्रू आउट हिज लाइफ. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, who was born in 1869, played a key role in India's fight for independence. He was assassinated on January 30, 1948, almost 5 months after he led India to freedom from British rule through a non-violent struggle.
Next, we take you to Manipur that recently got swept over by a wave of happiness as its unique Hathai chili and Tamenglong oranges gets GI or geographical indication tag. While Hathai chili is famous for its vibrant red color and flavor, Tamenglong's oranges are famous for its acidic taste and well-blended sweetness. Take a look.
What a great start to the day for Manipur, tweets the state's chief minister N. Biren Singh as he expresses his happiness over the grant of GI tag to two products of Manipur, namely Hathai chili and Tamenglong orange. He also described it as a historic milestone in the history of the state, which will increase the income of farmers immensely. Sirarikong village in Manipur's Ukhrul district is a place where Hathai chili is predominantly grown. It is considered as God's gift by the locals and it is believed to have been discovered by them when they were hunting in the forest. Hathai grows over 8 inches and is rich in calcium, vitamin C and packed with antioxidants. It is said to be useful in treating cancer and other diseases. It is usually grown under shifting cultivation on the slopes whose well-drained loamy soil is excellent for its growth. Moreover, As this area receives good rainfall spread over 6 to 8 months, farmers can cultivate this chili without irrigation because of the high moisture content in the soil. Siarakong villagers are expressing happiness to get a GI tag for the chili and say this will boost the state's economy.
See, ekoina hairabde yamna nungaiba aigi wakhalonda go aduga aingaknate kunjam yamchu yamna nungaiba phawgi maramdi prithibi na hujik ekoi bo masakhang bire haibise ekoi dup mati ki nungaiba phawjai haibise haijading ekoi thadok pa yadrabni na lou bising gi de sigi income si leibni na war so wana adum honna jai adubu
Tamenglong orange, which is the species of mandarin group, is another crop to be awarded with GI tag. This orange is bigger in size, weighing 232.76 grams on average, and has a unique taste and is rich in ascorbic acid. It is mostly found in Tamenglong district of Manipur, which is also known as the state's orange bowl and contributes over 50% of the state's annual production of the orange. It was Manipur Organic Mission Agency that applied for GI tags of Tamenglong orange and Siarakong Hathai chili in 2019. The organization is aimed at promoting organic farming and related activities in Manipur. Its project director said the farmer community involved in the cultivation of these crops will now be able to derive huge monetary benefits.
This is indeed a very, very great success, I should say, for the department as well as for the entire community of farmers who are growing Siarakong Hathai as well as Tamenglong Orange. Because once this GI has been obtained or GI tag has been obtained, they can go forward with a proper market linkage, and it, because it will increase the visibility across the globe. They have the ownership now, as well as the branding things that may come in the that they may put in the packaging, and others will really enhance the marketing prospect of their commodities or products.
The GI status is an indication that identifies goods as produced from a particular area which has special quality attributable to its geographical origin and have a great potential to play a major role in trade and tourism. Besides Hathai chili and Tamenglong orange, there are two more agricultural products from Manipur that have been granted GI tag. One is the state's black rice, which is known for its special aroma, and a unique variety of lemon, the Kachai lemon, which is cultivated in the Kachai village of Ukhrul district. Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section, World in Focus.
Kikkoman has risen as one of the best soy sauces all over the world. Now, it is used not only for Japanese washoku, but also for other global dishes. Kikkoman, a soy sauce maker in Noda City, Chifa Prefecture, has a long history of 100 years. Throughout its long history, it continues to preserve traditional soy sauce and contributes to the seasoning of world dishes.
The original form of soy sauce was introduced from China in 1200s. And like other things introduced from China, soy sauce was modified to fit Japanese food culture after 400 years since the original soy sauce was introduced. About the same time, our founding family started soy sauce manufacturing. Mogi, Takanashi, and Horikiri family had a great role in terms of development of the soy sauce industry in the region. Noda locates close to the major production area of our raw materials, which means soybeans, wheat, and salt. And between two major rivers, Tone River and Edo River, and we utilize those waterway for our business. So we gather our raw materials by using Tone River, and we ship product to Edo City by using Edo River. It took us only half a day to deliver our product to Edo. 8 family-owned brewing company decides to merge into one corporation in 1917. It was a great idea because then we could enjoy a larger capital, which means we can invest in major project. We ship out our product from that new manufacturing facility in 1925, 80 years after merger.
During and after World War II, the soy sauce industry declined. Kikkoman preserved its original soy sauce. Kikkoman's enthusiasm for making soy sauce enriches world's food culture. Hot air balloons of different shapes and colors roam the sky above Jordan's famous Wadi Rum site during the kingdom's first hot air balloon festival. Easy to spot in the blue sky and high above the desert, the hot air balloons attracted many who gathered on the festival site to follow the slow drifting of the aircrafts.
الهدف من المهرجان زي ما حكيت لك ضرورة إيجاد منتج سياحي يتم تسويقه خارجيا وداخليا. الأردن صراحة وخصوصا قطاع السياحة عانى كثيرا خلال السنتين اللي فاتوا من موضوع الكورونا فإحنا جهودنا يعني إحنا واجبنا كأردنيين وحريصين على هذا البلد إحنا من واجبنا إنه نساعد في عملية الريكفري من الكوفيد 19.
The festival aims to boost the country's tourism sector following the harsh blow of the coronavirus pandemic. Tourists can stay in surrounding camps, offering them a full outdoor experience amid the site's rocky hills. The festival ran till October 5. International University of Japan, IUJ, is in Niigata Prefecture. It's a global university. English is a common language among students. Foreign students can study Japanese based on their requirement. Because of the coronavirus pandemic, most of the students couldn't attend the ceremony physically, and the ceremony was also delivered online. Aeon 1% Club scholarship based on the principle that the major Aeon Group companies donate 1% of their pre-tax profits to contribute to the society and global tie. 2 students from Vietnam and Indonesia, supported by Aeon 1% Club scholarship, participated online.
We only put it in the landfill, and then there will be no kind of recycle technology. That's why we need to learn, Vietnamese people need to learn more about the experience in Japan, and then try to apply.
Aeon ga atarashi koto o manabi, hito to tsunagaru koto ai suru toshite, 子どものための森の精神の癒しプロジェクト、災害救援、食事、地元の森林プログラムなどをイオン 1% クラブプロジェクトに参加する機会があれば、私は信じられないほど幸せです。
Second grade students supported by Aeon 1% Club Scholarship have enjoyed study and various activity to absorb deep knowledge.
I'm studying international relations, so that allowed me to focus and understand the regional politics as well as global politics. IUJ has a lot of unique faculty from different backgrounds and studies, as well as it has a great study materials and support facilities. It supported me tremendously well during my studies right now.
Aeon Principal is establishing a worldwide network steadily and developing future global talents.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Skyrim, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.